Way Doc hasn't looked at the film, at the videotape. He said when he got to that portion of the tape, he fast forwarded. He didn't want to see it. And I can certainly understand why.
Doc said he never saw the Theismann injury.
Yeah.
See, I don't believe that. People see it and they turn away. So they see it and they, I don't want to see it.
Right.
But they turn away because they saw it.
Right.
Right.
It's... I don't like looking at it either.
No, not in terms of the grotesque factor, but in terms of the guts and determination and the performance after the injury. Does that find itself in the conversation with the bloody sock?
Yes.
With Willis Reed, by the way, which I think is slightly overrated. I know that's blasphemy in New York. I think he made two baskets in that game.
Two hoops. The first two hoops.
Right.
Total of 4 points in a 113-99
right.
win. It was much like Rondo. I mean, what Rondo did isn't in the box score. If it were, you know, it might be ugly. What Rondo did had nothing to do with points,
inspirational,
assists,
which is what Willis Reed was.
Which is what makes it so memorable and makes it so important going forward. If you're the Heat, you're not thinking about matchups and X's and O's, aren't you? You're thinking about, are we tough enough?
Right.
To match up with them,
right?
You know, do we have the guts and the courage and
all? Wade and LeBron both addressed it afterwards.
Right.
We're talking about a championship mentality here, he said,
and that's
what we're trying to defeat.
We talked about it for the first two games. You know, the Heat were falling hard. The Heat were yapping and
athletic.
You know, no, but they were trying. You know, when Wade hit the pick of Pierce,
yes,
it was to show they're not going to back down.
Right.
You know, when James Jones came down hard on Pierce, it was all a part of the plan. It was all a mentality for the Heat to show that they can match toughness with the Celtics. You know, if it were all even, you know,
right,
the Heat are better. You know, the Heat are more talented, more athletic, but the Celtics have the championship pedigree and they have the guts and all the intangibles are checkmark Boston.
The crazy factor goes to the Celtics.
Absolutely. So if you're Miami, you have to prove something. Now, what happened Saturday? Bosch was slowed by a crook in his neck.
Well, he slept funny, Jerry. Come on.
And Rondo's elbow bent that way,
right,
and he came back in the game. So that was more than a game, more than one game. That was a statement thing. That was a message. That was a huge blow to the Heat. I'm sorry if I'm getting swept up and I sound like Jack Edwards now, but it was a big turning point. The Heat spent 2 days in Boston wondering, you know, are we really that as tough as they are?
Yeah.
No, can we match up with that, with what we saw Saturday night?
To make the Osama reference, it wasn't two in the hat that Bin Laden took, but it was the one in the thigh that his wife did, is what the Celtics did.
Did you see Wilbon at halftime on Saturday? I was thinking of all he said was, see what the Celtics get for trading Kendrick Perkins. If they had Kendrick Perkins right now, they would have an answer for Joel Anthony.
He said that. At halftime,
it was like the Heat were up by 20 rather than two. They all thought the game was over.
Joel Anthony was operating with impunity out there, was he?
He was. He was.
Could have used Andrew Bynum for at least a couple of seconds on him.
But, I mean, do you see why they needed Jeff Green? Or I shouldn't say Jeff Green.
No, you don't.
Player
X. Yeah. Yeah. Tony Allen. Jeff Green. Shane Battier,
Tony Allen,
not Jeff
wasn't
Green.
Available. Shane Battier wasn't available. I don't want to ruin your argument. Wasn't available, okay?
By the way, wasn't available. Yeah, and the Green era is over, Dino, after this playoffs. He's an unrestricted free agent if they don't pick up his contract, which is $5.9 million next year.
Well, I heard Danny with Ordway on Friday and said he's playing great basketball. And I said, I know Danny's forgotten more about hoops than I've ever known. But I would, under no set of circumstances, qualify what we've seen from Jeff Green as playing great basketball.
Saturday night?
Any night.